And you know what? Asi mentioned yesterday that Tani is the riff master and that you are very good at writing lyrics. What would you say Asi is great at?
Singing. And he comes up with lyrics as well. He's a good lyricist. And he's a good front man.
He's very charismatic and he has a very particular voice. Do you remember what you think about his voice the very first time you listened to him singing?
I didn't have a good voice when I was like, grew on me.
Well, I obviously loved it because I wouldn't have been in the band with him otherwise, would I?
He's you know, not good.
There's
he's
no mathematical explanation for it. It's like, I have done Black Sabbath songs in my solo career on stage, but no one played Black Sabbath like Black Sabbath. Nobody, the original, you can't beat the original. It's like, if you paint, the guy that painted the Mona Lisa couldn't do it, he could do it same thing twice, but it's not the Mona Lisa, you know. You can't, you can do a representation of it, but it's never the same.
And it was, we all started together as well. It was like a jigsaw puzzle. Like, if I hadn't started with Ozzy, I wouldn't have played bass the way I do, and Tony and Bill, because I'd never played bass before, so they had sort of a trust in me. And we all moulded into that sound together.
Asi, is it easier for you to be around the guys you've grown up with and being around them? It's the three of you in Sabbath, it's just you while being solo.
Well, that's a different, completely different thing. It's just Black Sabbath now. It took me about a few gigs to get myself back in Black Sabbath because I'm so used to going on my own that, you know, it's not Ozzy Osbourne. It's not Ozzy Osbourne and Black Sabbath. It's Black Sabbath. And it took me a while, a few gigs, to get back down to being Black Sabbath.
And Geezer, I wonder if you were able to be around Tommy when he was diagnosed with his illness after being alongside Ronnie.
Yeah, well, I was with Tony and Ronnie and me were in the same band at the same time, and it was a big shock, especially after what happened to Ronnie, because you always expect it's going to be the same with Tony, because I don't know the difference in different cancers and stuff, but so he caught it in the very early stages, whereas Ronnie, by the time he went, he was inoperable.
And would you say that it might made you think about getting back together now, because it might be too late after Ronnie's passing away?
No, it's nothing to do with Ronnie. It's, we've always wanted to do a better album than Never Say Die, and we tried it before and it didn't really work. And this time it just felt the right thing to do. And Tony didn't get diagnosed until halfway through.
And I've read that you asked it, and you guys decided to record your voice in a lower register, so
yeah,
it's
yeah.
going to be easier for you to sing the songs live. Is that true?
That's true.
Is it easier for you to sing?
When I used to do stuff in the other days, I'd do what I call record songs and live songs. But I used to do tricks where I used to do a verse, take a break, go a higher range, and so on. This song, Rick Rubin made us do it from start to finish, and so you couldn't do the tricks, you know. So, and plus the fact, I always wanted to do some newer stuff on stage.
And you've mentioned the long songs you did this time, and you obviously did that before. And I remember that back in the day, you said that you didn't know what to do on stage. What is it
like? Yeah, but, you know, I said a lot of things. I said when I got married to my first wife, I didn't want to get divorced and get another wife. It's just, I mean, you say to you can't hold people what they're saying. 15 years ago, because we all changed.
Runs around the stage now while we're playing.
Yes.
Jumps on the PA and everything.
And that's a very good jewelry that you're wearing. I'll say, would you please tell me if you get it done for you? You ask someone to do that for you, or just buy it?
What are you talking about?
The rings and collars and stuff like that?
Oh, it's sort of stuff that I've accumulated over the years.
What's that?
Stuff that I've picked up over the years already for a long time.
And I read in a book that your father made you guys the very first crucifixes.
Yeah, the aluminum crosses. I still have my original one in my safe. It's very precious to me. My father made it, and it was the first piece of jewelry we had. We all had them in the beginning.
And is it true that you asked him to make those pieces for you guys because you were afraid of some ghosts and stuff like that?
Something old piece of jewelry.
Somebody did put a curse on us, and the head of the White Magic Church in England called us up and said to ward off any evil curses.
And you've told many times that when you first started out, and you've seen the movie Black Sabbath, where you took the name of the band from, and you tried to do that with your...
Yes, still do. Mm-hmm.
That's what I was gonna ask you. It was easier to scare people back in 1969 because you were the first band doing this. Nowadays,
it's scary horror and ghosts and all that. Scary war and religion and crime and all that kind of stuff. That's what we were singing about, and that's what we're still singing about now. Mm-hmm. Technology, everything else.
I'm from Argentina. You're going to be playing on October the 6th, and you're going to be playing with Megadeth. I wonder if you know that Megadeth released an album called 13 a couple of years ago.
Yeah. So we were two of us
in 13. And Suicidal Tendencies.
Yeah, they did too this year. You've been playing some songs from the new album. Do you think that when the tour ends, you guys are going to be played the whole album live? I mean, not the whole album on the same show, but maybe in different shows playing all the songs.
Maybe, yeah. Because we're gonna be doing USA, then South America, and then Europe. So we might change it all around for each part of the world.
It sounds very similar to Planet Caravan. Yeah. Were you after that consciously?
Yeah, Tony came up at the last minute, and he says we've got no acoustic slow acoustic stuff on the album, and he just picked his guitar up and started playing that, and I put the bass along to it. Ozzy came up with a vocal line, I wrote the lyrics, and that was it, it's done.
Did you ever play Planet Caravan live?
I don't think so. Have you ever played?
No.
Would you like to play Side Guys live? Is it a song to play live, or
I
is it difficult?
I don't think so, no. It's more of an album track, mm-hmm. But you never know.
Okay, thank you guys.
Okay, cheers.
Waiting for you in Argentina.